It's time for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares, Hour with the stars of Too Close for Comfort. Tonight, Cornell, Deborah Van Valkenburgh, J. Bullock, and the stars of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Raver and John Bauman.
Okay. Thank you. You're very kind. Okay.
Another bunch of cretins.
They're mine. They're all mine. So lay out. No, listen, we appreciate your enthusiasm, and since this is the end of the week, we're going to end up with a big flourish, aren't we?
Yes, it's
going to
be just...
We're going to be wonderful.
Yes, just getting into our stride.
We're going to be witty.
Enjoy talking to you.
What? Are you hurting?
I ran into this piece of metal here. Oh,
you hurt your foot?
Elsewhere, please.
Is it better?
Well, listen. I'm fine now, thank you.
One big
Boy,
awe will cure anything.
What a sympathetic crowd here.
All right, let's get underway by meeting our two contestants over here. Here's Mike Watanabe and Michelle Meyer. Yay! Watanabe?
That's right.
Does that mean anything?
Well, I think it's supposed to be descended from samurai, but I really don't know.
Really? You bring your sword?
No, I didn't.
All right. Where are you from, Mike?
Well, I'm from Plymouth Meeting, which is outside of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. And I work for a major computer company, and I'm out here on vacation and enjoying every minute.
Yay. Well, you'll have a lot more fun here if you win, won't you?
Yeah, sure will.
Okay, good luck to Mike, and now let's hear from Michelle.
Hi, Gene.
Hi.
I'm a domestic teacher, nurse, and culinary expert. I'm a housewife.
You are.
I have three children, one of which is my husband.
Is he here?
No, he's not, thank goodness. That's about it.
That's your life.
That's
eh?
My life.
All right, good luck to you too,
thank
Michelle.
You.
Here in the Match Game, the one who's matched the most celebrities will go on to challenge the returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Mike, you won the toss. You go first. You have a choice of A or B.
How about A?
How about A? You want to know what A says?
Mm-hmm.
Here's what it says.
Okay.
Little Tommy said.
Yeah.
Here we go. He said, boy, is my father mean. Other kids get to play with toys. My dad is so mean, he told me to go play with a blank. A mean father.
He could be pretty mean.
You don't know anything about being a mean father because
you're a sweet father. I don't understand. I'm a good father.
You're a good father.
So mean. Okay.
I see what you mean.
Yes. Hard to get it all together.
Right. You're finished, right, Jim? Yeah, we'll go to Mike. Little Tommy said, boy, is my father mean. Other kids get to play with toys. My dad is so mean, he told me to go play with a blank.
A gun?
A gun, that's a good answer.
Oh, that's okay. Me.
Oh.
That's me. Yeah. Go play with a gun, kid.
See, it's interesting what everybody says, isn't it?
It's revealing psychologically.
It's very revealing psychologically. Mine is really... What you, I say go play in the traffic.
Go play in the traffic. Yeah.
Yes.
That's good.
That, yes, you know that. Thank you.
That's why we get along so traffic. Well. I also said right. Traffic.
I don't know how you arrived at it, unless you misunderstood me.
I did, as you read it now, I can see...
They like to play with a traffic.
With the traffic.
He told me to go play with a traffic.
Yes, with the traffic.
With the traffic.
To play with a traffic.
Yeah, we didn't let
Liddy.
It's a good thing I didn't copy them. Okay.
As she usually does.
Grenade.
Grenade is good.
That's really good.
That says with the, and I didn't know
what do you got for us, John?
I got something entirely different. A bulldozer.
Another good one. Anything that would be dangerous
so
is okay
much.
Here.
You cretins. The
Deborah?
Cretins have returned.
I said buzzsaw.
Yeah, another bad, dangerous thing.
Oh,
my father was so mean.
Yes.
He told me to go out and play with a real gun.
A real gun.
We didn't hear with the...
Jim.
What?
Against the blue background, the green mask looks wonderful.
Does it really?
Yeah, it really does. I just watched it on the monitor.
Run over there. Listen to our article.
Just take a quick look at the monitor there. Right over there. Wait a minute. Can't sit down. What's wrong with this chair?
The Green Hornet.
All right, let's go
in that game. Now, wait a minute. No, you need a microphone. You can't do it without a microphone. And I have the mic.
He didn't all right. know that.
Mr. Watanabe, you got one. Michelle, you have a chance to catch up with your first round kid.
Yeah,
Captain Farrillo said.
Who?
You all who know who Captain Farrillo is.
Sure, he used to play for the Dodgers.
Right.
Who's that?
He said, since NBC cut the budget on Hill Street Blues, I can't afford a siren for my squad car. Now I just strap the NBC peacock to my roof and blank it. A rather involved question, but you do understand it.
I strap the NBC.
Trying to get, yeah. I strap the NBC peacock to my roof and blank it. In other words, he doesn't have a siren. He's going to get the peacock to make some kind of noise, right? Did you have your socks off?
Oh.
Oh.
Do you want to see my answer?
I strapped the NBC peacock to the roof and blanket.
Oh, can I play?
Please be our guest.
You're supposed to.
Oh, please.
Wait a minute. My light was don't write.
No, it doesn't.
Oh,
don't
please
write.
Back
when Mike is up, you don't write because you match him already. I was wondering what you were doing there.
Okay, well, I didn't. I thought it said don't ride.
Wondering all week.
Michelle, Captain Farrillo said, since NBC cut the budget on Hill Street Blues, I can't afford a siren for my squad car. Now I just strapped the NBC peacock to my roof and blanket.
I squeeze it?
Squeeze it. That'd make it make a noise, right? Anything to get it to respond. Nancy?
Squeeze it. They do make the worst noise in the world. You do know
yeah,
that.
Yeah, they do.
Raucous.
Squeeze it.
Squeeze
it.
Very good. Yay.
We're tuned in.
Oh,
we're tuned
in. Yay.
Yay.
Honk.
Honk.
Sorry.
Honk, honk.
And we didn't look.
All right, John.
What any self-respecting young man would do to a peacock or a gander, you goose it.
That'll make a man know.
You goose it.
All right.
That makes
sense. Strap the NBC peacock to my roof
goose,
and blanket, Deborah.
I said goose it, too.
You said that. Jim, what came to your mind?
I was way out in left field because I hit my foot hurt. So I put plucked it.
All right. Well, that would make the peacock make a noise, no doubt. So the score at the end of round one, 2-1, and Michelle's favor, round two, right after this. We go with round two. Michelle, you're ahead. You have to go first.
I'll take A, please.
Let's see what A does to you. Four people play. Lydia in the lower tier. Don Meredith said, you all know Don Meredith,
sure.
Right?
He's
right.
My
Andy
eyes.
No. Don Meredith. He said, I think that was Howard Cosell's car that just went by. The bumper sticker said, I love my blank. I think that was Howard Cosell's car that just went by.
You know, the more I play this game, the more I really hate this music.
Give it to me.
What'd you put? What'd you put?
Jimmy.
I haven't put anything down.
That's good.
Jimmy.
Wow.
Lydia's ready.
Oh.
Forget it!
All right, here we go. Oh, wait. Okay. Michelle, Don Meredith said, I think that was Howard Cosell's car that just went by. The bumper sticker said, I love my blank.
My toupee?
My toupee. Okay. Lydia, what do you say?
Oh, boy. Okay, I love myself.
Myself? Yeah.
That's a good one.
Two or three good answers here.
I also said I love myself.
I love myself.
I said it.
Deborah?
Well, it's the same thing. Hair.
Hey! Good for you. Jim?
I love my toupee. Oh,
toupee.
Thank you, Nancy. Thank you.
You're up to four. Now, Mike, you got a little catching up to do. You need three to tie her at this junction of the game. Mona said.
Mona.
Mona. Mona said, I think the nanny I hired used to work in a donut shop. Instead of using talcum powder, she rolled the baby in blank.
Oh, I wish I could play this one. I think I know the answer.
Ready, Deborah?
The sound men hate me.
Here we go. Mike.
We're going to chroma key the next answer.
Mona said, I think the nanny I hired used to work in a donut shop. Instead of using talcum powder, she rolled the baby in blank.
Flour.
Flour. That would be something they use in a donut shop. All right, Nancy. He said flour.
Well, oh, do I love donuts, but sugar.
Sugar. Powdered sugar, it looks a little like flour, Ted.
I guess baking powder doesn't apply.
Baking powder looks like flour, but it's not flour. Lydia?
Oh, boy. Simple minds, no, great minds think alike.
All right. Flour. Okay, 4-2, Mike. John?
I said the powdered sugar, that's what gets all over you and makes a mess. I'm so sorry. Oh, it's a beautiful answer, though, don't you think?
Debbie?
Yes.
Confectioner's sugar?
Powdered sugar. What is it, Jimmy?
All right.
I don't get to play.
Oh, you don't get to play.
So at this point, it's 4-2. Michelle, you're still ahead, and we've got one more round to go, and we'll see who wins right after this. Here we go with the third and final round. Michelle, you're still ahead. You have to go first.
Okay, I'll take A again, please.
A again. Two people play. Lydia and John. Now, you've all heard the song that goes, the sun will come out tomorrow.
Sung... Make your bottom dollar.
Right.
We know that.
Yeah. Not quite like that.
Cost him a lot of
well, there's a new song.
Yeah?
It's sung by old man Periwinkle. And it's called, My Blank Will Come Out Tomorrow.
Sung by what?
You don't play.
I know.
You can sing it. My blank will come
old
out.
Old man Periwinkle.
Yeah. Okay. All right.
Hey, you have a guy. Hey.
Michelle. Hey. You know the song from Annie?
Hey, hey,
sung
hey,
by
stop.
A little child. Sun will come out tomorrow. Well, there's a new song sung by old man Periwinkle, and it's called My Blank Will Come Out Tomorrow.
Only thing I could think of was teeth.
Teeth is good. For old man Periwinkle. Lydia, does she advance or does she stay where she is?
Teeth.
Oh. She does advance. You got five. You need one more for a perfect score here.
Cesare Siepi sings Annie. My teeth will come out tomorrow.
You could tie this game if you match the four stars you've not matched.
Boy.
Nancy, Ted, John, and Deborah.
Oh.
Lydia and Jim lay out. Dundora was so dumb.
How dumb was she?
When she ran out of deodorant pads, she put blank pads under her arms. That's how dumb she was. All right, Mike. Dumb Dora was so dumb. When she ran out of deodorant pads, she put blank pads under her arms. Dumb.
Dumb, dumb.
Pads.
I'm on a mattress.
You can't think of anything. How would she get a mattress under her arms? Yeah. Mike, I hope you have a wonderful trip back to
Pennsylvania, is it?
That's right.
Pennsylvania, it's a wonderful state. They love you in Pennsylvania. Goodbye, Mike. Gonna get a lot of gifts. We're gonna send you 27 pairs of pantyhose and things you'll really love here. All right, you gotta match everybody.
If you perspire a lot, that's not a bad idea.
Right.
I, however, said Brillo.
Brillo pads, everybody said that. Brillo, Brillo, Brillo. Pleasure to meet you. We are going to send you some wonderful gifts. Mike Watanabe. All right, we're very happy for you. It's time now to switch to Hollywood Squares. We bring out our other three stars. Here comes the rest of the set. And it's going to bang into place there. And John and I will switch spots here. We've got lots more excitement, so don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive the Silver Leaf Penman, fully electronic compact 80-wheel typewriter, practical enough for the home, durable enough for the office, furnished by Silver Leaf. And now, it's time for more of The Match Game, Hollywood Squares, our with from Too Close for Comfort, Elyse Knight, Arsenio Hall, Bart, Braverman. And taking over the star of the Hollywood Square, John Bauman.
Okay, we'll be back to play Hollywood Squares in just a minute.
And now, John Bauman and the Hollywood Square.
Okay, thank you. Welcome to the second half of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Welcome once again to Michelle Meyer. She has navigated the Match Game and Natch the Match Game. She's ready to move on to Hollywood Squares. We also have three brand new lustrous celebrities. Arsenio Hall. Yeah! The beautiful Elyse Knight. Yeah! And the interesting looking Bart Braverman.
Yeah! Hi.
Reminds many of us of a famous Hungarian actor. Arsenio.
How you doing?
How's showbiz treating you, Arsenio?
Hello.
Tell us about your life today. Yeah. How's showbiz treating you?
Everything's going real good. I just did a special with Dom DeLuise and doing a lot of things on the Alan Thicke show. And I got a new comedy concept coming out with one of the other networks. They're going to do something very unusual. I'm going to have a show where I'm a kid and I have black parents, which is kind of interesting. Yeah, they're going to call it Extremely Different Strokes, John, and I'm looking forward
to that. Well, it sounds very exciting, and stick with that other network, Arsenio. Meanwhile, on this network, let's go play Hollywood Squares. Michelle Meyer, here we go. You've had a pretty nice time on this network the last couple of days, haven't you? Yes, your name is Joyce Reeves, am I correct?
That's right.
Your total is $33,050.
Can you lend me a fin?
No. Joyce, now what goes through your mind? You've been on 2 days, you've won the Super Match both times. What did you think right before you started the first day?
You can get a brother out of jail now.
I mean, does anything run through? Do you have any expectations, or you just try to relax and forget about it?
I'm dazed completely.
I would think because it's been 2 days, you haven't missed a trick. You've done very, very well, and you got another chance today. We're gonna hear you play this game until we hear the time's up bell, and then the winner is gonna go on to play Super Match. You have won a 20 and a 10 in succession. What happens after that is you could win the $30,000, of course, and the first game is worth $100 plus $25 for every square that is captured. You start. Pick a star, Joyce.
10, please.
And we're off with Hollywood Squares. Ted Knight,
yes.
When it comes to eggs, do most hens prefer to do their laying in the light or in the darkness?
The hens that I have known
and loved
and eaten all need light. So I would say light is quite necessary.
Agree or disagree, Joyce, for the first square?
I agree.
Most hens prefer to do their laying in the light. Ooh. You are right to agree. You get the first square. Okay, she's got an X up there. You're playing. Oh, Michelle, pick a star.
Jim, please.
Jim Bullock.
Jim.
Yes.
Recently, the U.S. Army spent $20,000 to prepare pamphlets teaching our soldiers to do this. Is it how to play King of the Hill or how to cha-cha?
Or wear earrings. Play King of the Hill or cha-cha?
We spent $20,000, the U.S. Army spent $20,000 teaching soldiers to play either King of the Hill or to cha-cha.
$20,000 to King of the Hill or cha-cha? Yeah,
Joyce could make that in a day.
They're both pretty stupid. I'll say
King of the Hill.
What do you say, Michelle?
I agree.
It is. It's how to play King of the Hill. I guess that would be more applicable than how to cha-cha, at least. You get the square. There's an X and an O up there. And you are playing X. Ms. Reeves, pick a star.
Bart, please.
Bart Braverman.
Hello.
You were on the show Vegas, weren't you?
Yes, I was.
This is appropriate.
And I probably still am in some parts of the country.
What came first, Bart? The first Las Vegas casino or the discovery of polyester?
You should know that one.
The first Vegas casino or the discovery of polyester? Well, I know more or less when the first Vegas casino was, and I...
Look at the lining of your suit.
Polyester. I think polyester came first.
What do you think, Joyce?
I agree.
The first Vegas casino came first. No, you should have disagreed with Bart. Your opponent gets that square. And there's a big difference. 1931 for the first Las Vegas casino. Polyester did not come until 1953. Okay, we're going to break for a couple of messages, and we're going to come back and finish our $100 game. We hope.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Now, back to John Bauman at the Hollywood Square.
We all like this show. Okay, $50 to $25. Michelle, you're in the lead, but more importantly, you got two O's up there, and it's your move.
Lydia to win, please.
Oh, no.
Lydia Cornell from Too Close for Comfort. Yeah. If you are like the majority of women surveyed in Glamour magazine, do you wish your breasts were bigger? Or are you satisfied with them the way they are?
This one. Okay, the majority of women in Glamour magazine wish they were bigger.
For the game. For the game, Michelle, agree or disagree? Do you remember the question?
Yeah, I do. I disagree.
She disagrees for the game. This is very important.
Shut up.
And most women surveyed in Glamour magazine are satisfied with them the way they are. That is very good playing. You get the square. You win the game. Well done. Okay, she knew when to disagree with Lydia, and that puts you into the lead. You got 175.25 for you, Joyce, but still early. Just sweep those three O's and the X off the board, and we're going to start a $200 game with you, Joyce.
Ted, please.
Ted Knight.
I will help you as much as I can. Trust me.
Thank you.
Ted, at a formal dinner, you are served hard-shelled crabs.
Had some last night.
Should you carefully use a pick to remove the meat from the legs, or is it okay to suck the legs? Please don't act this one out, Jim. Thank you. Yes, Ted?
Gross as it may seem, some of the most delicious parts of the crab's legs are when you suck them out of the tubular bone. So I say yes, suck those crabs.
He says suck those legs. Joyce, agree or disagree?
We're having a crab second party.
I disagree.
Pardon me?
I disagree.
Hold on, she disagreed? It is okay to suck the legs. No, you should have agreed. It's perfectly fine. Your opponent gets that square. It's okay to suck the legs, but our source says try to do it quietly.
He couldn't help it.
Okay. Michelle, you got 1-0. You're playing.
Deborah, please.
All right.
Oh, no.
Deborah Van Valkenburgh. You have just washed your pantyhose. Can you dry them in the exhaust from your car? Or is that stupid?
That I think is pretty stupid.
What do you say, Michelle?
I agree.
It's stupid. Yeah, you're right to agree. You get the square. The exhaust from your car will make your pantyhose dissolve. Okay, Joyce, you are playing X.
Elyse to block, please.
Mm-hmm. You missed this one. It's a pretty big lead for your opponent. Elyse Knight. In America today, are there more people over 65 or under 5?
Over 65.
To block, agree or disagree?
I agree.
There are more people over 65. Well done. You got the square. And you do block. And the next goes up there. So, yes, Ted.
I happen to know that there are over 30,000 people over 100 in this country.
Really?
That's true.
Well, we might get to that question someday.
I am getting close, and I'm worried. So I look these things up.
Okay, Michelle, she thwarted you over there, but you're still playing O, and you're still well in the game.
Jim, Gene, please.
Yes, Jim Raver.
I hope so.
Yes. Well, we look a lot alike. We're the same age and all that. It's, I know, it's easy to make that mistake.
You have an identical, twin brother.
His name is Jim.
Yeah. No, Arsenio Braverman. Are your fingerprints also identical, or are they different?
Well, the things, they're called whorls. The lines in your fingers that make the prints. And there are no two alike in the world, whether you are identical twins or not. Makes no difference whatsoever.
So there are no two whorls in the world alike.
That's
your fingerprints
exactly
are always different. Agree or disagree?
Always different.
I agree.
Fingerprints are always different, even with identical twins. Yes, you're right to agree. You get the square. And she's got a bunch of O's up there now, Joyce. You are playing X, make your move.
Bart, please.
Yeah. Black. You missed this one. The game belongs to Michelle.
No pressure, however.
Don't worry, Bart. Can you train your chihuahua to use kitty litter? Or are you wasting your time?
Well, you're wasting a time by having a chihuahua. Can you train your chihuahua to use kitty litter? Chihuahua's a dog. I think you can train a dog to do virtually anything. Kitty litter, anyway, is one of the things you can. You couldn't train him to, like, have a cigar and walk outside, but I would go with kitty litter, yes.
Yes, he says you can't train your chihuahua to use kitty litter for a block. Agree or disagree?
I agree.
You can train your chihuahua to use kitty litter. Yes, you're right to agree. You're probably still wasting your time, but you can train it to use kitty litter. Okay, Michelle, your move.
Jim to win.
Okay, I'll try my very darndest for you, I promise.
Jim, according to Mary Ellen, can you freeze a banana, or will that ruin the flavor?
Who's Mary Ellen?
She does a thing called Mary Ellen's Helpful Hints. Jim.
Helpful Hints from Mary Ellen?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, like Hints from Halloween stuff. Okay, yeah, okay. Can you freeze a banana, or will that ruin the flavor? I've been to Universal Studios, and they have chocolate frozen bananas, so I think you can freeze them.
He says you can freeze.
I think you can.
Okay. Do you agree?
I mean, I know you can. But
do you agree or disagree, Michelle?
I disagree.
You can freeze a banana. No, that could be pivotal. You should have agreed, and your opponent gets that square. Okay. Hold on, guys. Joyce. Joyce, you're back in it. Make your move.
Arsenio to win, please.
To win.
That's Arsenio. Arsenio. It usually takes an opossum 12 to 14 days to do this. Is it to digest a meal, to make love, or to give birth?
We're talking about a possum? Did you say?
Yes, or an opossum, sure.
We're talking about a slow animal. I'm going to go with making love.
He says it takes 12 to 14 days for that possum to make love. For the game, agree or disagree?
I disagree.
It takes 12 to 14 days for an opossum to give birth. Oh. You're right to disagree. You get the square and you win the game. Very well done. Interesting, huh? Okay. Congratulations, Joyce. You are in the lead, 325 to 250. But we're going to go to a commercial, and we're going to come back to play a $300 game. Boy, those Lamaze glasses must be tough. Okay, she's come from behind and forged into the lead. But Michelle, we're going to play another game for $300. You start.
Ted, please.
Mr. Knight.
Ah.
What did Howard Cosell do before he became a sports announcer? Was he a lawyer or a TV news anchorman?
Being an anchorman, I can tell you unequivocally that he was not an anchorman. I happen to know Howard, and I am a big fan of his, and he does have the expertise of legal knowledge. He was a lawyer.
What do you say, Michelle?
I agree.
He was a lawyer. You were right to agree. Well done. You get the first square. Okay. Madam X, your move.
Arsenio, please.
Arsenio Hall. Okay, you have written your grocery list on your hand with a marking pen. After you finish shopping, Arsenio, what can you use to take the ink off? Is it nail polish or toothpaste?
I hope he uses a white magic marker.
Leave it to Jim to go for the racial humor.
Okay, we're gonna get into this afterwards, buddy.
I'll get you back for that.
Ooh, bad.
I think nail polish would get it, because nail polish will, you know, take a lot of things off.
He says nail polish will remove that magic marker. What do you say, Joyce?
I disagree.
Toothpaste it is. Well done. You were right to disagree. You get the square, and it's even up. We got an X, and we got an O, and we got a call from you.
Bart, please.
Hi, how you doing?
Bart.
Yes.
20 minutes ago, your dog and his girlfriend finished mating.
The dog and who?
Your dog and his girlfriend.
Oh, his girlfriend. Oh,
sure. Yes, your dog and his girlfriend finished mating.
All right.
However, they are still stuck together.
Not surprising.
Tacky.
Should you leave them alone? Or should you hose them down until they separate?
You know, God, what a question. I hate to admit a thing like this, but
I'm leaving.
I've seen this done a lot of times. I've seen people pour water on dogs, you know, when they're stuck in that awkward position. And I've always thought that it was a little bizarre, and I've never seen it work either. I had to leave them alone, and I put them in a private room by themselves so they could talk it over.
Hold okay. down your rider.
He says, leave the dog alone.
I agree.
You agree?
Yes.
Yeah, you leave your dog alone. They'll separate on their own. Well done. You get the square. Couple O's. Okay. Joyce, your move. You're playing X.
Gene to block, please.
Oh, brother.
Okay. You missed this one. Michelle forges into the lead. Gene Rayburn, which came first? The Fred Astaire movie Top Hat or the first tuxedo sold off the rack?
You should know.
I would say the first tuxedo sold off the rack came before Fred's movie.
What do you say, Joyce, to block?
I agree.
The first tuxedo sold off the rack. You were right to agree. You get the square, and you do block. That first schmato was sold in 1924. 1924, before even there were talkies. Okay, Michelle, you are thwarted there. It's your move.
Nancy to block.
You missed this one. A big lead belongs to Joyce. Nancy Dussault from Too Close for Comfort. Your husband likes to make love on Sunday morning, but you feel funny doing it just before going to Mass. According to Dear Abby, should you compromise and do it when you get home, or should you discuss it with your priest?
Oh, right, I'm sure.
What a question. I think, I don't know what I, that's not necessarily what I do, but I think that they would suggest you discuss it with a priest because it is a problem of your own feelings and emotions and religion. So discuss it with your priest.
Okay. What do you say, Michelle? This is for a block.
I disagree.
You should discuss it with your priest. You should have agreed with Nancy. She made the proper choice. Your opponent gets a square and wins another game. We'll all have to get our own syndicated column in order to find out whether that's the right answer. Okay, $700 to $300. An F game is worth $400. Those are a lot of figures. Sweep the X's and O's off the board, and let's get started, Michelle.
Ted, please.
What
Ted
Knight.
My dear. Hi, how's it going?
Well, who's been around longer, Ted? Ronald Reagan or Clairol hair dye?
Naturally.
I would say, of course, that our very fine president was around longer.
Is that Ronald Reagan? Oh,
yes.
Oh, just checking. What do you say, Michelle? Innocent question. What do you say?
I'm wearing this suit.
Ronald Reagan has been around longer. Yes. Clairol came in 1932. You get the square. Okay. Joyce, you're playing X. Pick a star.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
Ready.
You are dining at a lobster restaurant.
Yes.
And the waiter wants to put a bib on you. According to the book of modern table manners, will you look ridiculous if you're older than five? Or should you just accept the bib?
No. You know, if he gives you a nice kiss, then you accept the bib and you don't make any fuss about it. That's all there is to it. You just put the bib on.
What do you say, Joyce?
I agree.
Yeah, just certainly. Put the bib on. You're right to agree, you get the square. That's a simple enough question. You never know in this game. Okay, Michelle, you are playing O.
Jim, please.
Jim Bullock.
Frozen bananas.
What's faster, Jim? Orson Welles running as fast as he can?
Oh, that's fast. Mm.
The other. Or the top speed of the Goodyear blimp?
Two dogs stuck together. I'm still stuck on.
Can somebody
that
host Jim down and get him to answer
that? Frozen
that
dog one.
Yeah. Then mask. The Goodyear blimp or him, huh? Let's see. Yeah. I would say that definitely the Goodyear blimp, please.
I agree.
What do you say, Michelle? It is the top speed of the Goodyear blimp.
Thank you.
Yes, makes sense. That's 50 miles an hour. 50 miles an hour, the fastest the Goodyear blimp can go. Time is up. Our winner, $725. She has done it again. Joyce Reeves. All right. I don't know. You might be related to George Reeves, who used to play Superman. You are Superwoman this week. Very well done. Go over there. Join Gene Rayburn and his lovely pocket hanky that he got from the lobster restaurant. Get sent me a shot at the big money. Okay. Michelle.
Yes.
Well, you certainly are up against a tough champ. She's established that very well. You certainly were more than in the game. You're leaving here with a very high total for someone who's leaving. $350. Very well
great
done.
Time.
Thanks for playing.
Thank you.
Michelle Meyer. Okay, Gene, take it away.
Thank you, John. Congratulations to the current champ. We'll be back with her and our stars. There we go with the big money right after this. And now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn. Okay, Gene Wood, here we go. Well, Joyce is no stranger to this part of the game because she has over $33,000. She's been up here before. She knows she could win an additional $30,000 here. Good luck to you. Let's begin. We polled a recent studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank Thomas. If you give us the answer that they wrote down most often, you get $1,000. For choosing the second most popular, $500. And for the third, $250. All right, one at a time, if you please, slowly.
Arsenio.
What do you say, Arsenio?
Let's go with Danny.
You want to go with Danny?
Yeah.
All right. He wants to go with you. All right, there's one.
Ted, please.
I agree. Being an anchorman, I have to say Lowell. Lowell Thomas.
Lowell Thomas. All right.
John.
I'm going to give you Marlo.
Marlo Thomas?
Yeah.
All right, so we have two members of the same band. Danny Thomas, Marlo Thomas, and Lowell Thomas are the three they've given you. Now you have the option of choosing one of those or thinking up one of your own.
Danny Thomas.
You want Danny Thomas. Let's find out if Danny Thomas is up there. I guess Danny Thomas, they think Danny Thomas is up there. Well, we'll slowly reveal it beginning down at the bottom. The $250 response, please. Doubting Thomas.
Sure. He's in that same family, Jesus.
Related to Danny Thomas, yeah. Right. All right, the next one says Marlo.
Marlo!
Oh, boy.
Seems logical to me that Danny Thomas would be on top. Let's slide the big one, if you please. And yes, sir. Yay! 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 All right, Joyce, you've got the $1,000. Now it's time for the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. And after you've made your decision, that star will reveal the hidden number. We'll multiply your $1,000 by whatever that number is. It'll be a 10, a 20, or a 30. Ready now to choose a star.
Arsenio.
All right. Grab the tab and give it a pull. $10,000 is what you are playing for. All right. If you match Arsenio on this, you'll be over $40,000. $43,000-something. Good luck to you. Static blank. S-T-A-T-I-C. Static blank.
Hello?
Arsenio is ready to collect the $10,000. All you have to do is match him. What do you say to that? Static?
Electricity.
Electricity. Arsenio, she says static electricity will match you for the 10 grand.
I had static cling.
Static cling. Oh! Yes, I would have thought a woman would have thought of static cling first. Do you ever have that problem?
Constantly.
Constantly. Anyway, you got a total of $34,779. Congratulations on that. We'll be back to you and our stars right after this. All right, now, we all want to know which star had the big 3-0. Would you all grab the tabs and give it a yank?
Here we go.
Elyse Knight had it.
Elyse Knight.
Elyse. Listen, while I have your attention, stars, since this is the end of the week, John,
for a change,
I want to thank you for your lively participation here.
We'll see
all of you back here some other day, okay?
Wonderful. Okay, we'll see you all on Too Close for Comfort.
Too Close for Comfort.
Probably including Bart and Arsenio.
Right. See you on Monday. And Gene Rayburn here inviting you to join us on Monday.
And John Babbitt saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Goodbye!
A member of our studio audience will receive Tappan's Deluxe Microwave Ovenry Tappan Touch Controls, built-in browner, 10 different cooking speeds, so you can program to defrost and cook automatically furnished by Tappan. Speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, a Mark Goodson television production.